Aussie we all know, where the western breezes blow. From north to south he's known far and wide. Henry Lawson was his name, but he never rose to fame until he crossed beyond the great divide. In a little place called Grenfell, when the gold was flowing free and the miners and their money came and went, in 1867 when the town was on the spree, Henry Lawson, he was born there in a tent. He grew into a lanky lad when Gulgong was his home. His mind was bright, he had those itchy feet. He wrote a string of verses of the days he used to roam from the dusty track out back to City Street. He drifted with the drovers across the western plains, and he waltzed Matilda down the Lachlan side. From the Barcoo to the Murray, in droughts and flooding rains, oh, the bush was both his mother and his bride. He passed by plain and mountain and by burning desert sand, by shearing shed and lonely cattle camp. And when the beer was flowing, he was there to lend a hand with the mates that shared his life upon the tramp. He sang of wild bush brumbies, of teamsters and their teams, of outer tracks that only bushmen know. He saw the mail coach coming by plains and mountain streams, and he wrote about the lights of Cobb and Co. He told of lonely men out back and women of the West, of folk that fought to live in factory towns. But the swaggies of the old bush school were those he knew the best, where the waters of the Darling wander down. He boiled his billy back of Burke and starved in City Park. He penned his poems in a shaky scrawl. But of all the old bush poets that have passed and left their mark, Henry Lawson was the greatest of them all. There's an Aussie we all know, where the western breezes blow. From north to south he's known far and wide. Henry Lawson was his name, but he never rose to fame until he crossed beyond the great divide. Until he crossed beyond the great divide.